up on this Sunday morning. It's a staple of the city, but once upon a time, it was considered a failure.
Hard to imagine that, but that's where our next guest stepped in. We're sitting down with the woman who helped save Radio City Music Hall from the wrecking ball. You're watching Today in New York.
Welcome back. 1 week from today, we're going to be talking about the Tonys, and they're being held right next door from us here at Radio City Music Hall. This year, the building, of course, is a historical landmark, but did you know it almost got torn down in the 70s? I know. Our guest this morning is one of the reasons it is still standing, and she wrote a book about it, too. Rosemary Novellino-Mearns, welcome, and thank you for everything.
Thank you.
I know it was a group of people.
Yes, it was. I didn't do it by myself.
But you have kind of written the story here. Take us back to the, you know, for those of us around here, remember the 1970s in New York were tough. Ugh. The city was bankrupt. Yeah. The financial scene was down, and Radio City was on the chopping block.
It absolutely was. It used to be a movie palace, the best, the largest, most famous movie palace in the world. And the films used to be top of the line. If they showed Radio City Music Hall, they were instant success. And then somewhere in the mid-70s, the films started to get a little funky, and then they got really bad. And they started losing money. And then this announcement was made. We were working there. I was in the ballet company, and my husband and my boyfriend at the time was a singer there, and the audiences weren't there. The curtain would go up, and sometimes there were more of us on stage than in the audience.
We think today of the Rockettes, but when people went to see a movie there, it mm-hmm. wasn't just a movie. There were a lot of troops that were based out of there.
There was a movie and stage show all day long. The stage shows, we performed them four times a day. The movies ran five times a day, and it was a full show. There was a full ballet company, of course, the world famous Rockettes, a chorus of singers. Sometimes there were specialty acts that came in, and the show could be anywhere between 30 minutes to 45, depending on the length of the movie.
And maybe for our younger viewers, if they've ever seen the movie Annie, when they go to Radio City, there's a musical.
There's a great shot there. Yes,
musical number there. Well, yeah. The experience. So the plan was to just knock it down and build a.
They were
going to
tear, tear it down and build a glass box like we see all over the city. And when they made the announcement. Bill, my husband, and I were captains of our departments. I was captain of the ballet, he was captain of the singers. And the night before, we were sort of asked to come to a strange early morning news conference.
And they were going to, and you, and
they didn't tell us what it was about.
And what you articulate in your book, Saving Radio City Music Hall, is this was a grassroots effort to save it, and it was successful.
Yes, we were. When they made the announcement, the shock wore off, I got angry. I got really, really mad because I loved the building. And the first thing I did was I made a phone call to here, to NBC.
You're on the Today Show for that.
And that phone call led to another phone call, and soon I was invited to be on some shows, talk shows. And the next day I said to Bill, we have to do something now. We can't wait. And we called a meeting of all the employees, and 300 people showed up in the large rehearsal hall staring at me. And I said to them, we have nothing to lose. We have to do this. And that's how it started.
And it succeeded.
Yes,
we can
did.
Only imagine, you know, so much we lose over time.
Yes.
We think of Penn Station. We think of things like that. You know, the developers, wrecking ball sometimes, that you helped save Radio City.
Yes, I did.
We all owe you a great debt.
Oh, well, that's very, very, very nice. Thank you.
And what a cherished landmark.
Absolutely. It is a landmark. It is a national landmark.
Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
You and your
thank
old
you.
Did back
Thank
in the
you.
Day. The book is Saving Radio City Music Hall, A Dancer's True Story. Rosemary Novellino-Mearns, thank you for being here. Do check it out. If you like New York history, it's a fun read. We're coming right back with more Today in New York right after this.